My name is Greg Berman, Managing Director at Citadel Securities. Recently, there's been a lot of discussion about tick sizes in the market and whether or not the rule that prevents quoting in sub-pennies has somehow created an unlevel playing field between exchanges and off-exchange venues such as Citadel Securities. So what are tick sizes? Tick sizes in the U.S. market are the minimum increment by which you can quote a stock. You will see stock prices of $20, $20 and one penny, $20 and two pennies. You will never see a quote of $20 and 1.5 pennies or 2 2/3 pennies. About a year ago, we produced a white paper on market structure, and one of our recommendations was that the SEC change the rules and for stocks that are trading already with a one penny spread, that they allow those stocks to go lower, perhaps to a half of a penny. We've had to revisit the idea of sub-penny tick sizes because more recently, certain participants in the market have suggested and proposed that in addition to changing the tick sizes for stocks that clearly would benefit by that, that instead tick sizes are changed for all stocks, regardless of what the spread of those stocks are. We looked at publicly available data to determine whether tick sizes were constraining exchanges from providing the same level of price improvement to retail investors that we can at Citadel Securities. This table presents our results from data across all stocks. As you can see in the far left column, we have the names of each of the venues that we've analyzed, Citadel Securities and many of the different exchanges. But the most important column is the second from the right, where we present the amount of net price improvement in cents per share that each venue is able to provide. And we've ranked them from largest to smallest. And as you can see, Citadel Securities is clearly at the top with 0.64 cents per share of price improvement. Some have looked at that and say that that number is the evidence that suggests that tick sizes need to go lower. They need to go sub-penny because if Citadel can provide 0.64 cents, maybe exchanges could do the same thing if only they were allowed to quote at tighter increments than a penny. What we decided to do was to rerun the same analysis, but instead of looking at all stocks, we wanted to look at stocks that had wide spreads, spreads of 20 cents, 30 cents, 40 cents. They're some of the most popular. Google, Amazon, Tesla, all have wide spreads. For these stocks, we see that Citadel Securities is providing a net price improvement of over 13 cents per share. Once again, this is significantly higher than the amount of price improvement that exchanges have provided on this same set of stocks. The key finding for this table is that there is ample room for quotes on exchanges and trading on exchanges to go from the price improvement levels that they have, 2 cents, 3 cents, 4 cents, and improve another 5, 6, 10 cents to match the pricing improvement that Citadel Securities is able to provide. Market participants say they can't provide better prices because of tick sizes. We looked at the data and tick sizes are not a constraint. So if they're not a constraint, they can provide better pricing if they want to. Hence, it doesn't really make any sense to change tick sizes for all stocks when those tick sizes are not preventing market participants from providing better prices today.